Hello and welcome to this full tutorial and overview of Apple's Journal application. So here we are. I'm going to tap into the application. I have it locked behind my Face ID on my iPhone, and you can see all of my recent posts. Now, I'm going to be honest with you. I've always wanted to journal, but because of systems and apps overload and just complication, I've never done it. But I'll be honest with you, utilizing Apple's Journal app has really changed that because of how easy it is. So when you open the app, you're going to see a lot of different things. You'll see recommendations that Apple wants you to use for a new post, but let's just get started from the top. If you hit the addition symbol, it will then bring up the prompt to begin a new entry. They'll be recommended and recent for your photos, workouts, and things like that, reflections from your Apple Health app. So basically all of the apps that Apple, you know, has and provides to you, you'll see suggestions from that. And it says here, Journal only has access to the suggestions you choose to write about, which means like pictures and things that you give it access to. So let's start from the top here. If you go to New Entry at the very top, it's going to give you a blank canvas where you can begin writing about your day. What I've really liked to do is I just hit the microphone right there below my keyboard and I just start speaking, and as I speak, you can see it starts typing what I say. So I'll do it on my afternoon walk, or I'll do it the next morning as I'm getting ready, or whatever it may be, you know, to take away the complications of finding time to do this. Now, you can edit it, format it very simply by just using the keyboard here. Now, the cool thing about this app is that it allows you to do a number of things with the media that you're already taking and capturing throughout the day and the week. So if we go right here and go icon by icon, the pencil icon with the glowy option there, that's just going to be suggestions that we saw just a few seconds ago. You can see recommended or recents depending on your, you know, apps that you're using. Next will be the photos tab where it has access to your photos. You just select photos and then just select a photo that you want to add, and it will automatically add that to your post. You just tap it again to remove it. Also, if you tap into the camera app, you'll give it access to the camera. And as you can see, I can take pictures directly here within the app. Go ahead and go to use photo, and you'll see it adds that photo directly to that post. Tap the X icon in the corner of that image, and that'll remove that image that you just took. Next is going to be the waveform or the audio option. If we tap into audio here, you'll need to allow access to the microphone. So tap continue, allow it to use your microphone, and then you just tap and record. As you tap right here, you'll see that the audio is recording just like that, and then you'll just stop, and that audio file will be added to that journal post. So you have pictures that you've already taken, you have the camera you can use there, and then you have the audio where you can record audio. Next is going to be the locations option here. Let's say you're at a soccer practice for your kid. You can go to search locations and you can just go and find a soccer complex like this here, wherever it may be, and add an actual location so you can remember not just the images and audio, but you can also remember where you were. And as with anything, tap the X to remove that element from your post. So as you can see, we have images and videos work as well. I just recently did one of my daughter at volleyball practice, and as you can see there, there she is in that video on that post. And when you tap into a post, you can kind of expand it, see when you did that, and then you can kind of see the video that you just posted. Now, once we're back here into our new entry, couple of things. You can bookmark a post if you want to always look at it at the top. So if we go into a post here and we see this one right here, I can actually go and edit that, and then I can bookmark that. And if I hit done here, you can see no matter how many posts I post, that will be at the very top. That's a favorite or bookmark. And in order to edit a post that you've already done, you just tap those three dots, tap into edit, and then you're back into the editing of that specific journal post. Now, the next thing I want to show you is the three dots with a circle around it right there next to the date. If we tap into the three dots, you can see that it's going to automatically start the entry date as whatever today's date is. But if you happen to miss something, like you missed yesterday or the day before, you can go to custom date and you can choose and backdate. You can't, you know, I guess you can go forward if you want, but you can backdate it to be whatever you want it to be, and you can do multiple posts in one day if you want to. So just select the day there that you want to add it to. Now, couple of things that I want to show you is once you hear and you've started making some posts, you can hit the filter option in the upper right-hand corner of these three horizontal lines with a circle around it. And we can see here that we can filter by all entries. We can filter by places that we've tagged. We can filter by things that have photos, videos, or just bookmarked posts. So if we tap just bookmarked, it's only going to show us the ones that are bookmarked due to that filter. But if we go to all entries, you can see that here. Again, if you tap the three dots on a post, you can either you can remove a bookmark there, you can edit it, or you can delete by tapping the red delete button and go to delete entry just like that. So a couple of little hand gestures within the app. If you swipe over to the right, you can bookmark it from this page here. If you swipe to the left, you can actually delete or edit by going here by swiping to the left. That will completely remove that. So if we have an option here and we've already typed something and we go done, if we swipe to the left here, you can see it will automatically bring up the prompt to delete that entry. And that's really it. You can always go back in, tap into a post, go to the three dots, go to edit, go over things, add things after the fact if you want to. But I really do like this app. I like what Apple's trying to do with it. And I love just the simplistic nature of being able to go in and add images and photos and, you know, talk about and write about my day. So that's it. Let me know what you think. Hopefully this helped you. Are you going to start journaling with this app? Let me know in the comment section below. If you have any further questions, you can put those there as well. I try to get to them as soon as I can. Like, share, and subscribe if this helped you, and I will see you guys in the next video.